What's up, everyone? I'm gonna take you on a walk through Quebec City, Canada today, through the Saint-Roch neighborhood. I'll be walking through here to the Limoilou neighborhood across the St. Charles River. I'm starting off this walk on St. Joseph Street. This is one of the most lively parts of downtown. It's got a lot of hip bars, restaurants, and eateries. I recorded this video on Wednesday, December 14th, 2022. Temperature is 38 Fahrenheit, 3 degrees Celsius. And the time right now is about 11:15 a.m. We are in the middle of the holiday season, so you'll see a lot of these lamp posts that are decorated. Each one is outfitted with a Christmas tree as well. Japanese restaurant. There's a chain restaurant, Poutineville. Haven't tried it, but should be decent here since Quebec is known to have invented poutine. It's a specialty dish consisting of French fries with gravy and cheese curds. That's the basic recipe, but many restaurants have added to that. They put meat in there, they put different seasonings and other sauces. Quebec City is actually known for the old city, which is up on the hill. I don't think too many tourists come down to this part of town. I find it's quite charming here as well. All these brick-lined streets. A lot of cool mom and pop businesses all around St. Joseph Street. Some of these Christmas trees actually look like they're disconnected. They haven't been hooked up. I believe there's a convenience store. Also acts as a post office location. This building over to my right is the Saint-Roch Catholic Church. Really impressive structure. Okay. Here's a local Lebanese restaurant. This over here is Benjo, a well-known toy store in the area. I might even just pop in to take a look. I'm a little bit too small. I'm too big to use this door here. I'm not a VIP. Let's take a look. There's a beautiful toy store. There's certainly a lot to see in this store. Certainly a lot of stuffed animals and toys. Sesame Street. Got some painting kits. Certainly a really impressive selection. Take a look at this model Ferris wheel. The Lego collection. Oh my goodness, there's a model Empire State Building in the middle here. And there's the Chateau Frontenac at the top of Quebec City. Here's the puzzle section. Let's take a look at this big lion. Some more dolls in this section. Definitely very impressed with this store. I'm also impressed that they have a little entrance there for the children that grown-ups can't use. You're gonna have to drop down. Thank you. Bye-bye. Such an amazing toy store that you would never think. I wonder if the Saint-Roch Catholic Church is open right now. We can take a peek inside as well. I think they're doing a food drive right now at the church. Let's see if it's open. Maybe not. Coming up is a restaurant which I've eaten at before, Phil's Smoked Meat. Quebec is known for their smoked meats. The recipe came over when early Jewish immigrants immigrated from Europe and brought their recipe with them. It's really good here. And it's quite popular with the locals. Very similar to a pastrami from New York City. And the only other time I had a smoked meat sandwich was in Montreal at the legendary Schwartz's Deli. this area is very stunning to see. Gingerbread house, various Christmas trees of different sizes. Now I need to cross over again. Looks like this is going to be a library, a renovation of a library. I'm just guessing that's the word for library because it looks similar to bibliothèque in Spanish. Seems like a neat little cafe. Sushi shop. This store across the street, Jean Coutu, is a convenience store similar to CVS in the United States. The breads in this restaurant is really making me crave. I see two large shawarmas in the back there. Their meats must be really good in that restaurant, the Lebanese restaurant. It's a busy cafe at Nectar. Moroccan restaurant. a really impressive church building. Guess we'll cross now. African restaurant, Cherry Cocoa. But it doesn't look like it's open. They have a, I guess, for sale sign in the window. Another African restaurant. Oh, wait a second. It's a hair salon. Old electronics store. I even see a Guitar Hero controller. I remember playing that game. It's been a while. Now I'm making my way over to Langelier Boulevard. Actually, maybe I could walk on this median in the middle. It looks very inviting. Some of these structures are a little bit older and dated, you can tell. Just like this one over here. I don't even think this structure may be safe to inhabit. The corner of that building that looks like it's about to fall down. And you get to see many of the side streets too. definitely one of the more unique neighborhoods I've ever walked through. Very impressive architecture. So coming up over here is a hospital building. It's a very impressive sculpture. General Hospital. There's a small cemetery. Christmas tree. Now I'd like to go into Victoria Park, show a little bit of that off, and then we can walk over the bridge to Limoilou. That's a neighborhood which I haven't been to yet. Victoria Park. Mm-hmm. Oh, cool. They have baseball, tennis, restroom facilities, football or American soccer. Looks like a pretty good size public park. This looks like a sprinkler zone for the children. Local playground. It's a nice area with picnic tables, a dog run over there. Actually, this is not a dog run. Looks like a baseball field, but this guy right now is having his two dogs just run around and play. Let's see if I can exit the park and go over the bridge to Limoilou over here. Don't think I'll be able to get out here. Probably this way, and then I walk on the local street. Oh, interesting. There's a overpass here for cyclists and pedestrians. I believe this is the Quebec City police station. I'm actually looking at Google Maps, and supposedly this overpass looks like it might lead to like a waterfront area you can bike around, but I'm gonna go this way. Actually, it looks like I may need to cross the street. I should have taken that overpass. Oh, they have a stop sign. I might be able to still go in here somehow and go up. Is there an entryway? Let's see. I could have used the other door too. Not the best maintained of structures in Quebec City. At least it does the job. And that's the bridge I need to walk across. Maybe it'd be better for me to go down here. Is there a way to connect to that bridge from this ramp? I mean, it might be possible, but it doesn't really look like it. Yeah, let's go down the staircase. This structure is so ancient. Looks like it's been through a lot. Let's hope I'm able to walk across this bridge. Hope it's not a car-only bridge. Detour. Well, now there's a big construction site. This car is going. I guess I'm gonna have to walk around this. I'll just walk in the grass here. Yeah, I wouldn't have been able to cross over there at all. And there is a sidewalk. Bus 19 to Limoilou. Hello, how are you? Nice construction workers. Well, I guess I could have walked over there too on the rocks. I wonder if this is part of the waterfront path that I saw on Google Maps and where that overpass would have left me. Well, let's take a look just for a brief second. There is a lot of ice here, so I have to be careful. Yep, this is definitely it. And there was a way to connect to the bridge. The river is still thawing out from all the ice. It's barely above freezing. It's a very gorgeous sight. This is something else to see. And very, very nice waterfront path, if I may add, on both sides of the river. If I can translate that correctly, that sign says Linear Park of St. Charles River. It's also nice to know I could take the bus back if I need to from here. It looks like their main street is 3E Avenue, which is about two blocks from here. I'll probably head over there and look for a place to eat since it is lunchtime. It'd be nice to try a restaurant outside of the city center and out of the old city. These are Quebec City pedestrian crossings. You gotta put your hand under it to signal that you want to cross. This is a very interesting neighborhood. Nice wide streets. Various styles of housing. Even this barbershop, it looks like in a cool little building there with a nice cylinder. And I believe this is the main street now, 3E Avenue of Limoilou, Quebec City. Tim Hortons drive-thru. There's a nice cafe, Les Colloques. This looks like a very nice neighborhood. Reminds me of a lot of streets and cities I've walked through. Miyagi, Thai bistro, and sushi. Looks like they have a special. This looks like a very popular place. I like that little stage over there with the Christmas trees. Oh, wow. Well, here's a French restaurant, Fistin's. I think I may eat here. Thank you. I guess I could walk across there, and we'll end the video at the hashtag Limoilou. Someone's getting honked at for driving too slowly here. They don't know where they're going. Okay, here we are. Hashtag Limoilou. All right, everyone. I'll be wrapping up this video here and grabbing some food. If you enjoy this video, walking from the Saint-Roch neighborhood in Quebec City to Limoilou, checking out Victoria Park, then hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone. See you later.